Peace and blessing, peace and blessings. Your man, Herbal Lover, coming live and direct from your mama's basement. We're going to talk about that game. I was going to make that video last night, but I'm going to say this, you know, because I'm reading ESPN, and as a matter of fact, I'm going to read this first before we actually get into a lot of things. I just want to read something that Russell Westbrook brought out, and this is one thing about these analysts, these writers. You know, it's like I keep telling you fans, man, that's why you cannot just follow a lot of these writers and these analysts. I know I'm small in the corner, I only get like 100-something views, so you'll never really, I'll tell you like this. If I was an individual getting like over 20,000 views and all that, I bet these analysts will sit back and think about a lot of things I said. Because they target specifically certain agendas or certain elements in order to get you, the fans, to fall right in line with it. Shannon Sharp has said something about Russell Westbrook on Twitter about him turning the ball over. Something I forgot what it was. And I told him, I said, man, how you going to sit there and be biased? And you only talk about Russell Westbrook turning the ball over, but yet you seeing us getting killed in the inside by Reeds. And, you know, he never replied back to that, you know, and a lot of people liked it, whatever. But anyway, it's funny to me. So I'm going to read this off. This is from Dave, sorry if I butchered your name, Dave Manaman, ESPN staff writer. But you already know, I told y'all before, these guys, they're all in the same boat together. You know, once in a while you get somebody that might speak out that won't be a little bit biased, but a lot of these writers and analysts and all that, a lot of them are just biased, man. You know, they just follow along whatever the script tell them to write, and they add a little spin on it, but they stick to the script almost just steadily. But anyway, Russell Westbrook hit a key fourth quarter jump shot to push the Los Angeles Lakers lead from 4-6 in the eventual 108-103 win over the Minnesota Timberwolves on Sunday night. He also had 9 turnovers and shot 0-for-5 from 3, which helped allow the Wolves, missing 2 of their stars in Karl-Anthony Towns and D'Angelo Russell, because of the league health and safety protocol, to hang around so late in the game to begin with. I do not agree with, I mean, I agree with a lot of stuff here, but I'm going to have to share with y'all the thing I've been talking about even before, even during the time when Russell Westbrook was still turning the ball over. You know what I mean? The decision that we make according to our coaches, but I'm going to go ahead. Because, you know, we don't acknowledge this stuff. When asked what's the jump shot did for him, contributing in the big moment after not playing his best up to that point, Westbrook took umbrage with the question. I disagree, Westbrook said. I disagree with the part that the game wasn't going my way. Westbrook finished with 20 points on 7-for-16 shooting overall, hit 6-of-8 free throws, and also added 5 assists, 3 rebounds, and a steal, which implied were just as important as the misses or the miscues. My game, you know, is fine, he said. My game is not predicated on shots or if I turn the ball over. Like, I miss some shots. That's part of the game. I'm allowed to miss shots, which is true. I can do that, like any other player. I can do that. I can turn the ball over, too. Not 9 turnovers, Westbrook. Come on, bro. You got to be real, though. I can do that. That's all part of the game. See, the problem right here, see, this is the egos I'm talking about, man. LeBron, Davis, Westbrook, Carmelo Anthony. These are egos. These are egotistic individuals. And I said before in my video, when I first started making it this season, I said Dwight Howard will fall in that category, but he's a little bit more humble based on the fact of how he's being utilized. But those 4 guys right there, because they under LeBron James, they can say what they want and get away with what they want. This is the main reason why I see analysts and writers, they will just focus in on that one particular person. But who's the start of all this? That's what I be trying to tell fans at the end of the day. I know we quick to beat up on Westbrook. If you actually watch Westbrook throughout the years in his career, not just watching the Lakers game, but just watch Westbrook play. I watch him play with OKC. I watch him play with the Wizards. One thing about Westbrook is this. I told y'all he's 110% up and going, up and down the court, up and down. In order to play with Westbrook, you got to be able to be in tune with Westbrook's style of play. If you're not in tune with Westbrook's style of play, there's going to be a lot of turnovers. I'm just going to keep it real. Plus, you got to have a center that can actually catch the ball, because he does a lot of pick and rolls going to the paint where he, you know, draws the team and just kick it out to the center, who dunks it or lay it up or lobs it, whatever, how he sets it up for him. Because that's all him and Adams was doing. If you go back and watch the season where it was just him and Adams there, all he did was just penetrate. The team would come over to prevent him from getting close, you know, getting to the basket, and he would just drop it off to Adams for the dunk or layup. But because the Lakers don't run a center, it's kind of hard for him to play his style of play. But that goes to show you that the Lakers really don't run a playbook. They just don't run a playbook. Because if they run a playbook, they will actually make sure they run schemes beneficial to Westbrook and his style of play. But they don't. So Westbrook is a turnover machine. He turned the ball over more this season than he ever did in any other seasons. I'm just going to keep it real. But, you know, get back to the article. I can turn the ball over too. I can do that. That's all part of the game. Westbrook, the only player in league history to average a triple-double in four different seasons in his career, went on to explain the statistics that statistics don't tell the story of what he brings to the table to help his team win. When you watch basketball games and figure out what impacts making right plays, boxing out, rebounding, whatever that may be, making the right plays, making the right reads, that's all about being a basketball player, he said. As for the jumper, he hit a pull-up shot from 19 feet out that went in, even though Minnesota Anthony Edwards fouled him on the release and put LA up 99-93 with 4 minutes, 56 seconds remaining. Westbrook struck off any added significance to the score. And that shot, I mean, just a shot I worked on every day, he said. It didn't really do nothing for me, just that it had been there all night and I should have been taking it. While Westbrook wouldn't accept the characterization that he struggled on Sunday, it was obvious to other members of his team. Had a tough night tonight, said Lakers coach Frank Vogel. But he's improving, and we're evolving offensively. So the guys are in different spots, and some of that is the pieces moving around. And in that, it's not just him. Indeed, the Lakers went with a centerless lineup as they had recently with LeBron James man in the middle, despite being out rebound. See, look at this, man. Despite being out rebound 56-28 by the Wolves, Vogel never brought in either his traditional big Dwight Howard, DeAndre. Now this guy says something. Now he says something. Yeah, he never brought, you know, off the bench. LA is now 3-0 with James, and 3-0 with James, and assuming the 5 spot, and Sunday win brought the Lakers back to 500 at 19-19. While James backed Westbrook by saying, look, while James backed Westbrook by saying, just his presence on the floor helped us. He details how point guard turnover affect the Lakers on both ends. He was kicking himself a lot tonight with his turnover, especially in the first half, James said of Westbrook, turning it over 7 times before halftime. Clean up in the second half, only had 2 in the second half, which is better. That's true. And it resulted in us being able to get shots. And when we get shots, we're a really good team. What has really hurt us this year is when we turn the ball over a lot and not able to set our defense where we're really good in half court and have teams run it out on us. So us being able to take care of the ball in the second half was key in us getting the win tonight. The ball is in his hands a lot. The ball is in my hands a lot. So it started with the two of us being able to take care of the ball, and we did that. Westbrook said he cut his second half turnover total by just making easy reads. But that's when he started slowing down. But I mean, Carmelo Anthony was another one of Westbrook's teammates to take a delicate approach when describing how the former league MVP is playing. I don't think we have to be on him about what he does out there on the basketball court, the turnovers or anything like that. I'm recording. Okay, you have to make sure. The turnover, anything like that, because he beat himself up about it anyway. Anthony said, we're just there to support him, let him figure it out, and we'll be right by his side. I'll actually throw this link in there so y'all can read it, you know, verbatim, how y'all choose to read. I'm just tickly pink, man, off of this, man. Like I told y'all, before I even read the whole article, look how Carmelo, you know, they're going to come to his aid because they're the boys. They support one another. You know, egos support egos. And, you know, they're not going to let their man down. You know, the fans outside looking in, we see the atrocity of what's going on. But, like I said today, a lot of this fall off LeBron because LeBron was the one that brought all these guys in. So, the analysts and writers will continue to pick at Westbrook, but they won't really pick at the person who set it all up. But let's keep it real. The first half, yeah, he had 7 turnovers. The 7 turnovers, man, I'm telling you this, the 7 turnovers, then he slowed it down. This is going to have, he only had 2 turnovers, which is not bad. The first half, he was just a rat. He was crazy. But the thing about it, it's not so much that, man. I mean, we, like I said before, and I say it over and over again, if Towns was there and Russell was there, we'd have lost this game. I'm just going to keep it real with y'all. We'd have lost this game, man. Just going through the stats real quick. Johnson only played 21 minutes. Pretty good defense. You know, the young dude, man, he doesn't do much. He just played defense. Didn't really score, only had 1 point, but that's what he's really there for, just defensive presence. LeBron James, another, you know, he had 39 points, didn't really shoot the ball well. While didn't really get the chance to really shoot the ball, should I say. He did was 3-for-9 behind the three-point arc because they clawed that middle down. Patrick Beverley, based on the fact he plays LeBron enough, he told them guys, look, man, be physical with him. Be physical with him. When he come in here, bang bodies with him. Don't let him just come here and do what he want. If y'all didn't watch the game, that's what he was doing. They were taking the paint away from LeBron, not allowing LeBron to get what he want in the paint. Just going to attack the basket. They put 3 guys up front, be 3 guys hovered around that paint to make sure that when LeBron go, you're going to kick that ball out. You're going to beat us with a 3-pointer or a jump shot, or you're not getting up inside. So even though we criticize Westbrook, let's be honest, at the end of the day, Westbrook 20 points did help win this game. Because LeBron didn't drop no 30, and there wasn't no easy 26 points he got neither. People might not stand and realize that. Because most of his shots came where? The free throw line. He was 9-for-12 from free throw line because they were beating that boy up down low. They were beating him up, man. And I'm telling y'all, man, at the end of the day, you cannot continue to run this small lineup and think that you're going to be successful. It's not I don't know what's wrong with Vogel and all that. We should have blew these boys out. If you'd have brought Dwight Howard, and I'm hearing fans talking about Dwight Howard can't keep up playing. Listen, I'm going to tell you like this, man. A lot of you guys don't really watch NBA outside your favorite team. And I can tell, man, because I don't watch Dwight Howard cover around the perimeter. Dwight is not just a big who just stay in the paint and just slow up the paint like DeAndre Jordan. He can actually get out there on the perimeter and play defense. He can move around. Did y'all ever notice that when the Lakers switch out, he's out there playing some of the guards sometimes? Like, y'all just in there saying, like, oh, well, you can't stick nobody. Reeves is not a fast guy. He's not somebody that's going to put the ball on the floor and blow right past you. You know what I'm saying? He plays, Reeves is one of them individuals who play according to what is given to him. So, Minnesota coach at the beginning did the right thing. They attacked the basket. And what they was trying to do is get LeBron James to play defense, him and Carmelo to play defense at the beginning. The reason why? Because they look like this. They know that the Lakers are small, you know, in the front court, right? Well, small, you know, in that front. So in retrospect to that, why not attack the paint and get easy layups and put these guys in foul trouble? You know, they weren't successful, but they were hanging around. They were hanging around because of the dude Reeves. Let's keep it real. Reeves was the reason they hung around. And all the second chance points they got, man. You cannot win a game with all of them. They had like 17, 12. I will read the stats after a while. But I'm going to just go through it real quick. LeBron James, he was 7-for-15. Like I said, he didn't take a lot of shots. He was 9-for-12 from the free throw line. They were beating the crap out of him. Most of the shots came from the free throw. Lucky for the free throws, you know what I'm saying? We could have lost this game. That's the big thing about numbers that you have to understand and realize. He only had 7 rebounds. He had nobody on the starting five had an offensive rebound but Johnson. That's how bad we were getting out rebound, okay? We had LeBron James had 5 assists. That's me playing off of Westbrook. Westbrook, they closed everything down. They closed everything down to basically take everything away from LeBron James to make Westbrook make passes to other players. Luckily, like I told people, I love Monk. And I'm happy that Monk has got a lot of shots, 22 points. Avery Bradley came and stepped up. You know, you need players to step up when LeBron James is being, you know, when he's being double teamed and basically forced out of certain plays in order to get the ball up early. So Bradley and Monk stepped up. Monk been doing pretty good these last 3 or 4 games, so I'm happy for Monk. Bradley been stepping up. Like I said, Westbrook, 9 turnovers. He had 7 at the beginning when it was erratical. That's when Minnesota was just going at it, but also Minnesota was killed. See, we don't even acknowledge the other accolade. We just look at Westbrook turnovers. We only pay attention to the point of all the freaking second, third, fourth, fifth opportunities that the Minnesota Timberwolves were getting on their offense. You know, be able to put extra shots up or Reeves taking it straight to the basket. Or Beverly penetrating and kicking out the Reeves for a layup or a dunk, or Edwards just going in there for a layup and dunk, doing whatever they want inside the paint. We totally ignore that, but we just only focus on Westbrook turnovers, not knowing that there's other things and other elements that actually are killing us as well, that have been killing us since we decided to go small ball. And I've been saying this over and over again, these teams are getting what they want in the paint. And if you go against a physical type team, it's going to be pressure. And that's what this is. That's why I say, if Cat was here, Cat will be destroying LeBron James if Vogel would decide to let LeBron James play center. And probably, knowing him, he probably would have. I don't understand him. Anyway, it's just foolish to me. I would have Dwight playing. This coach is sorry, y'all. Y'all can keep on trying to protect this coach all you want. He sucks. Okay, the only thing protect him is because you got 4-star players that's protecting him. LeBron James, Westbrook, Carmelo, and who's the other 4? LeBron James, Westbrook, Carmelo, there's one more, ain't it? Oh, and Davis. So you got 4-star players that actually protect this man. This man was coaching somebody else like the Rockets, all that, man. That dude been gone, man. That dude sucked, man. Y'all, like I said, man, he's a sorry coach, man. You will put LeBron James, like I told you, LeBron James is not a defensive player like that. You know, especially when he's playing down low, it's a little different than you up on the perimeter and all that stuff. You down low banging bodies, then you got to bring the ball down. You tired. You can see it in him. The dude tired. I told you after a while he won't have no legs. You're doing too much. You got to play a center and trying to bring the ball down, helping Westbrook. You done gave up Rondo, so you ain't got no other real point guard to come off the bench to help them out when Westbrook is struggling. So you relying on LeBron James. That was a bad move as well. I know you trying to open up a spot in order to get Johnson on there. I guess that's what it was. But you could have basically just, I guess you could have opened up a spot with somebody else who haven't even played yet. But anyway, like I said before, the whole thing is just foolishness to me, man. Like you basically go ahead and say, you know what, we're going to drop, you know, a Rondo, which we need another true point guard to come off the bench. Why? Because when Westbrook are having these struggling games, this is a good opportunity for Rondo to come in for 5 or 6 minutes and help pick up the momentum. You can't let LeBron James be the point guard and the center on defense. Like, come on, man. That's stupid. That's crazy. But anyway, Anthony Davis had 14 points. Reza came in 12 minutes. Ain't really, you know, he had three. Ain't nobody else do no. Tucker, man, he's a shadow himself. Man, I don't even want to talk about that dude, man. Yeah, you know what I mean? Like I said, and that's my thing. You got Bazemore there. You got Howard there. You got Ellington there. Like I said, Howard should have came in, man. That's just me. Personally, like I said, as a fan, you know me, of basketball, man. I think that if they'd have brought Dwight Howard in there, they'd have blew Minnesota out, man. Because Dwight Howard, one thing about Dwight Howard is he's physical. He's not going to let them dudes just come in there and do what they want. And also on top of that, you're putting the Lakers under pressure by having them being out-rebound and out-scored in the paint. So now you basically say, okay, and that's another reason why, if you're going to tell you like this, that's another reason Westbrook, golly, I'm sorry, y'all, I was eating my food, man, and someone's got my throat. Anyway, Westbrook, one thing about Westbrook, when he becoming radical is when the teams are like, when the opposite team actually are putting up numbers and they actually are winning or on a run, he get anxiety or something. I don't know. It's just me. I'm just my opinion. And he just go off like he's just trying to help get the team back into the game, whatever. And I think he just do too much. That's my biggest problem with Westbrook. He just do too much. He try to do a lot. I understand you want to win. But at the same time, you know, the coach is the big reason behind this. But Minnesota, man, I'm going to go to Minnesota real quick, man. You had to do Edwards, you know, like I said, Edwards ain't really do nothing. He had 18 points, but the biggest, like I said, the biggest guy was Reeves, man. He was 10 for 17. He had 11 boards, man. He had 5 offensive boards, man. The starting 5 alone, that's 9, 10, 11, 12, 15 freaking offensive boards just by the starting 5, bro. And what they did is all they did was just attack the paint. Vanderbilt had 12 rebounds, 3 offensive. Edwards had 7, 2 offensive. Reeves had 11, 5 offensive. Beverly's had 9, 4 offensive. Beasley had 1 offensive. But like I said, Edwards had 18, Reeves had 23, Beverly had 12. He was he was 5 for 12. He had a 3-point off. Now I know Beverly can shoot. Remember Beverly when he was in the Clippers, he couldn't shoot worth a hell. He was just good for defense. Now the guy knows how to shoot a little bit, shooting a little bit better. Come on, Russell Westbrook, you can't be letting somebody like him outshine you. I'm just joking. But anyway, Beasley had 16, and they had to do Noel's. Come in, man. He had 17 points, man. But like I said, their biggest thing was the attack in the basket. Now, we go, you know, go to team stats, man. And then I'm going to end it right here, man. But I tell you, the biggest problem with the Lakers, yes, it's turnovers with Westbrook. Let's get it real. That's turnovers. But that's just one of the Lakers' problem. The other problem, we're going to talk about it right now. And then I'm going to let this video go because I don't want it to go over 30 minutes. All right, field goal. Lakers shot 48%. Minnesota shot 44%. Now, all we're going to say this too, in that last 4 minutes, Lakers actually did tighten up on their defense. You know, they actually prevented the guys from getting Minnesota getting in the paint. But let's keep this real, too. In that last 5 minutes, they took Reeves out. And they never brought Reeves back in. They never brought Reeves back in, which I think on Minnesota's behalf was stupid, especially if that was helping you win the game when the game was still close. I'd have went back down into the paint, plus Reeves could shoot. So in retrospect, I'd have went back down the paint. Now, LeBron James started playing better defense on him towards the end, but at the end of the day, it should never even came to that. This is a team that was missing two of their stars. The Lakers should have took full advantage of it by bringing Dwight in and let Dwight manhandle these dudes. And I keep telling people over again, but people just, somebody call me. But I just tell people over again that, you know, you got to basically manhandle these dudes. You can't let these dudes do what they want. And that's the biggest thing with the Lakers right now. They're letting these teams come in and do what they want and get what they want in the paint. And then the Lakers are fighting at the end trying to win a game when they could be blowing these teams out. But anyway, let's get to it because I'm going to end this video. It's almost 20 minutes in. 3-point percentage, Minnesota was 9 for 38, 23%. Now, I told you, they were actually attacking the basket. Lakers weren't shooting any better, 13 for 41, 31%. Free throws, they were 12 for 16. Minnesota didn't really go to free throw line as much as the Lakers did. I think that the free throw is another reason to help us overcome this opportunity of not losing. We were 23 for 29 with 79%. They shot, they only missed 6, which wasn't bad. Now rebounding, man. You're not going to win like this, bro. Minnesota had 56 rebounds today at 28. They had 20 offensive boards, bro. 12-4. Defensive rebounds, 36, 12-24. The assist was almost about the same, 21 to 20. 21 for them and 20 for us. They had 9 steals to our 14 steals. They had 2 blocks to our 5 blocks. Turnovers, you already know 9 of them came from Westbrook. So 9 and then the other 9 is spread out among your team. Total turnover, they had 24, we had 18. Points off turnovers, 21 for them and 16 for us. Fast breaks. Listen, see, this is the thing right there hurt us. This is where Westbrook excel at, fast break points. As you notice, the Lakers are not a fast break team. That's why Westbrook, it hurts this team when Westbrook turned the ball over, because he's the one, he's the guy that get up and down the floor. He's an up-tempo type of point guard. He's not one of them half-court set type off point guards. If you ever notice, when Westbrook played with another top-tier player and they go on half-court set, he usually gives the ball 90% of the time to that player. But that player usually don't do anything with it, but that's what he used to do. That's why he was so used to having somebody like Kevin Durant there, because Kevin Durant would usually get the ball and just take over. And, you know, he would try his little thing here and there, but most of the time it would be Kevin Durant. And that's why he always passes to LeBron, like going in that half. But LeBron is tired. You got him playing center, getting beat up with these physical guys down there. Somebody else got to step up. Luckily, we got Malik Monk. That's how I look at it. But anyway, we had 22 fouls. They had 22 out of 16. Look at the points in the paint. They had 58 points in the paint. And we only had 32. And this coach is not acknowledging that this right here, 58 points in the paint. Points off turnovers, 16, what's the other one? Rebounding, 56, offensive 20, and you don't make no adjustments, like bringing the Dwight Howard to slow the roll of the Minnesota Timberwolves. You let these boys play out, and if we'd have lost this game, everybody would be beating up on Westbrook. They wouldn't even say nothing about this freaking setup about how Vogel did not decide to let the Dwight Howard in the game, man. And if I'm telling y'all, if they continue to think they're going to win with this small ball, man, this not going to work. It's not going to work. You got to play Dwight Howard, man. You got to play him. Y'all know what's wrong with this coach, man. I can't ride with this coach, man. I can't ride with him. I can deal with Russell Westbrook because he's a player and LeBron James brought him here. But I can't ride with the coach, man, because a lot of this stuff could be overlooked. Not overlooked, but, you know, basically knocked out the park, whatever you want to call it. If the coach would just make better decisions. Just go back to the time we had Rondo and Westbrook, two non-shooters in the backcourt. It's like, yo, what are you doing? You know what I'm saying? And this at the time we had Reeves. But it is what it is, man. We got the win. Like I said before, it shouldn't have came down to that, man. For the life of me, man. Vogel, please put Dwight Howard in there, man. Free Dwight Howard, man. Throw a hashtag up, free Dwight Howard. This is crazy, man. We shouldn't have to be watching this, man. We shouldn't be watching a guy turn the ball over 7 times in the first half and Minnesota just attack into the basket. And you don't make a timeout and say, you know what? They beating LeBron up. They're going at LeBron. LeBron, and half the time you see LeBron, when they come in, LeBron just standing there. LeBron ain't going to get in the middle of that. He's standing there, right there, just standing right while they come in and lay up and dunk it. But nobody says nothing about that neither, right? That's why I say he's not a defender. Not with them physical dudes, like off the brick. He can play good defense, but down low in that paint, no, that ain't his game. All out the paint, yeah, he could, you know, because he got the strength to keep them guys from backing up. Because I know I seen the play where Reeves was trying to back LeBron up, and LeBron, you know, gave him body, prevented from backing up, and Reeves wanted to lose the ball but got it back. But when he in the paint, nah, you can hang that up, man. LeBron ain't one of them guys that can go straight up and block your shot. He got to get momentum going. He's not the young LeBron no more, man. And then in the reality of it, it probably worked with Anthony Davis at the power forward. It made sense then. But right now, nah, man, you got to let Dwight Howard play, man. You're putting too much pressure on LeBron. I know LeBron is the reason why all this is going on, because he had a hand in with Westbrook, and I always say that. But at the end of the day, you still have to make decisions of making better decisions when it comes to winning balls, man. It's just that simple. You got a freaking center there who can rebound and block shots and clog the paint up, but you're not going to put him in. Man, get the heck out of here. Man, this is your man, Herbal Love, reporting live direct from your mama's basement. I'm out.